We're here today to honor Marilyn June Dodson. As we understand that Marilyn has already been laid to rest and been in heaven for a while. And the story she could tell you would just really blow your mind and tell you it's nothing like today that's here on earth. Marilyn June Dodson was born on June 26, 1933, to Faye E. and Kuma E. Jones. She was married on December 31, 1951, to Kenneth Gene Dodson, who was born on April 21, 1931. Marilyn passed from this life on October 23, 2012. Marilyn and Kenneth had seven children. Cynthia A. Dodson of Florida, known as Cindy. Kenneth M. Dodson of Bend, Oregon, known as Mike. Dennis R. Dodson of Woodward, Oklahoma. Marilyn Joe Pierboy of Indianapolis, Indiana, known as Joy. Rebecca L. Caldwell of Wichita Falls, Texas, known as Becky. Laura E. Hensley of Oklahoma City, Oklahoma. Rhonda K. Smith of Oklahoma City, Oklahoma, known as Kim. Together, Marilyn and Kim had 11 grandchildren, 12 great-grandchildren, and one great-great-grandchild. Marilyn was retired from her job at the Oklahoma Board of Education out of Eternal Funding Payroll Department. She was also a learning center teacher. Marilyn died on doing what she loved to do most in life, spending time with her family. All you loved ones here, let it come to honor her. And she says, thank you. Thank you. She was a great mother and friend to everyone. She will be loved always. Rebecca L. Caldwell, she loved to talk and visit with anyone that she met. What she loved most in life was her family. There wasn't anything that she wouldn't do for her kids or grandkids. She put them first before herself. Marilyn had many illnesses, but didn't let any of them keep her down. Separate. Heavenly Father, as we have come here to honor you mostly for taking care of Marilyn and her family, for showing your love out, for you watching over them each and every day in things that they don't even see. Lord, we praise you. And we know Marilyn up there is visiting with her relatives, her friends she knew, her loved ones. And we just praise you for everything, Lord. Everything. So let this service, Lord, feel the presence of your being and to know the messages you have for them in Jesus' name. Folks, I want to tell you something about heaven. And Marilyn would want you to know this. She's experienced the things in heaven that we haven't experienced yet, but we will. Yes, one day soon, we will. The way the times are growing and things that's happening, it's coming faster and faster before our eyes than ever before. The mayor wants to pass on something to me. We see these commercials or television spiritual shows that when someone passes, we see white clouds that they're walking in, and the clouds are real heavy around their feet. Folks, it's not like that. The Bible tells us that heaven is beautiful. You look around here, you see colors on the walls, you see paintings, you see pictures, you see people in their colored clothes and their hair done up, and everything's so pretty. And everybody looks their best, and they're just trying to, you know, live life. But Marilyn wants to tell you that in heaven, things are vivid color. Things are so beautiful. The Bible speaks that the streets are gold, pure gold. It's not fake gold, fool's gold. God has given you the best there and now. But it's up to us to take what is now. Yes, it hurts to lose a loved one to the grave. But soon, when we go and meet Mary and others that have passed on, our eyes will be opened and we will be reassured of the beauty and the things that we read about are absolutely true. I know Mary wants to tell you that she loves each and every one of you. She's had stories. She's had times with you. And as I understand, Marilyn was kind of a jokester. She likes jokes. And you know, I met Laura at a chiropractor's office. And I know she jokes around. And I hear some of the workers say things, you know, well, Laura did this to me or something. It's always something funny. And I was asking Laura about her mother. And she said, oh yeah, she loved jokes and she loved to enjoy life. But most of all, she loved to be with her children, her grandchildren. She loved to talk. She loved to have enjoyment, relationship. And that's exactly what she wants you to have today. She also wants you to know that the Lord has showed her that here on earth, we do have authority. Jesus taught his disciples to have authority in life. But our words, believe it or not, are so powerful because we're a spirit in a body. He is spirit. And the words we speak are so powerful. We can cause people to be blessed, and we can cause people to be cursed. The scriptures talk about Balaam and Balak, how he could bless and how he could curse. And I'm not talking about the cursing and cussing. I'm talking about speaking bad about one another. Marilyn wants you to have life and have it happy. And most of all, she wants you to have love and compassion for each and every one of you, not just for the family or the grandchildren or people you know, but it's even strangers. No matter how bad they hurt you, she wants you to know, she's experienced this love in her heart, and she wants to relate that to you. I know this from Jesus Christ. I know this. The things that I have been experiencing myself lately has really put me in awe. It's not like before. Through the years before, that miracles and wonders, it says signs and wonders are happening in the later days. Folks, this is the later days. I'm having people call me up on the phone with cancer, with arteries clogged, with broken legs, bones, and they asked me to speak over them. But the Lord is the healer. And He always has been, and He always will be. Don't be afraid to call upon Him, but give Him your love every day. And the next time you see someone speaking out in anger, Marilyn, I want you to know, speak a blessing on her life. Have no hurt in your heart, but love. And I want to read something here in Mark 11, starting in verse 22. It says, "For have faith in God, for verily I say unto you, that whosoever shall say unto a mountain, be thou removed, and be cast into the sea, and shall not doubt in his heart, but shall believe that those things which he saith shall come to pass, he shall have whatsoever he saith. Therefore I say unto you, what things soever you desire, when you pray, believe that you have received them, and you shall have them." We've heard this message so much by ministers, but this is something I know, Marilyn, I want you to understand. Verse 25 and 26, "And when you stand praying, forgive. If you have aught against anyone, that your Father also is in heaven, that may forgive you for your trespasses. But if you do not forgive, neither will your Father, which is in heaven, forgive you of your trespasses." This is the biggest desire that Marilyn wants you to know. Forgive and love and treat people with love and compassion. She wants you there with her. And yes, folks, it will not be long. We see the picture of Marilyn up here that brings back memories. Each and every one of you, just relate. And things go in your mind. The Lord asked me to do a song called My Mother. I don't know if all of you have heard this song or not, but if you have, I'm going to do the very best I can and bring you the words. And you will see in this song, this is Mary. She got up to help her children, to help people, when she was tired and sick. But yet she got up and did the very best she could. It may be a little loud out there where you're at, but try to bear with it. Thank you.
Go ahead and have a line of detail. good attorney by then, and me. She's the best mom I ever had, and if I had a choice, I wouldn't want anybody but her. She never did no wrong, she never raised a hand, she never said a curse word to us, she was just... I don't know any other mother that would be like that.
And your name?
Yes.
Dennis. Amen. Amen. Is there anyone else?
But I know she loved me, but I miss her every day.
You know, I'm going to say something here that I heard the other day, and I have to be careful saying this, but I had heard, and I'm trying to check this out more, and I believe I found a scripture that presents it, but not positive at this time. But it is said that the ones that have went to heaven, they see the good things, only the good things that were done, your loved ones and so on. Now, I don't know. I have not got that confirmed, but I do want to pass it on. But here is your key. Always, always, if you want to speak to Marilyn, pray to Jesus. He will relate it. He relates things to us all the time. Of speaking over, isn't it funny how we have things in our mind of a person that we haven't seen in a long time? And then, in just a short time, we see that person. Or that person may call us, or we may run into them in the store. Folks, that's not coincidence. That's God's love. He wants you to pray for those people. It's not just to get back together and not see them for years or so on. But the Lord wants you to know, you will see Marilyn again. And again, she wants you to have your heart right, where you can live for eternity. And yes, you're going to have homes that is out of this world. And it is out of this world. You're going to have things and joy with each other. There's things up there that you think, well, I'd hate to give up this life. Because I can get my car and I can drive down the street, or I can go get a coat, or just go do whatever I want. Oh, folks, through the Spirit, I will tell you, you're going to have much, much, much more than that. Life is going to be abundant. The Lord says in His Word that He gives life more abundantly here on earth, but also in heaven. You will not be tormented by the devil. Sickness and disease is not going to come upon you. And we think, oh, I wish she was here, but we can pray for her to get rid of the sicknesses and the illness of her. Her, even you, we all have things on our bodies. But again, speak positive things in your own families. If you see a loved one in your household that's sick or have a headache, that's not natural. We all think it has because it's happened so much. But speak and pray. Lay your hands on that person. Take a deep breath and go do it if you haven't done it. And it gets stronger and stronger and stronger. I'm seeing things now, and this is why I'm telling you. Marilyn wants you to know that Jesus taught with authority. And she wants you to know you have authority over anything you do. And yes, there's going to be roadblocks, but you don't stop. You keep saying, no, I will have that. It says speak. And anything you desire, you shall have. But the key of it is pray and have love and compassion. compassion in your heart. I'm seeing children. I've got video of a little 8-year-old girl that I called her up, and her little knuckles was just as red and hurting so bad on both hands, what it's from, I don't know. Little timid, very shy little girl. Very slender. She stood probably about that tall. And her aunt says, Gary, would you pray over her? And I said, sure. It was in a meeting I had. Brought her up and I said, hon, over the mic and over the video. And if anyone wants this video, I'll go get it. I do not have it with me today, but I will. We're seeing things like this all the time. And I said, hon, does your hands burn and hurt? She feels yes. Kept her head down all the time. And I said, do you want Jesus to take that pain away from you right now? He will do it. And she said very softly, yes. A little voice, a little child is not going to lie to you. I laid my hands one on top, one on the bottom of her hands, and I rebuked that pain off of her in the name of Jesus. He gives you the authority to do this. You are a spirit. You are one with Christ. I took my hands off and I said, hon, how's your hands? Do they hurt? She sat there and took her hand and did this and then her other hand like this. I had asked her again. I said, hon, does your hands hurt and burn? She goes, no. And I said, well, do they hurt just a little bit? She said, no. I'm telling you, that lifts you up inside because you are a blessing through your prayers and through your speaking over people and especially your loved ones at home because you're planting a seed. Marilyn wants you to know this. She's experiencing this life and she's telling you it's great. She's telling you all the things that I have learned. I want to share with you. She's sharing this with you today. She wants you to be happy. And yes, things do come upon you. But you can go through it in the name of Jesus. Is there anyone else that would like to have a word?
I will say something. I usually don't have a problem speaking, y'all know this, but the only thing I can say about Grandma that is a complete reflection of her and the husband that she brought up. Was, I know they're my aunts and uncles, obviously, but I've never met a kinder group of people in my whole life. They are compassionate, loving, full of joy in their hearts. They're a complete reflection. Remember, one time I was an only child, we know that one of them scolded me. In an ill manner. They're beautiful people. You know, I agree with them within us. If I had to choose a group of people again, I would choose these people.
Amen.
They're beautiful, and I love you, and I don't know what it's like to lose a parent. Jimmy does. He lost his mom 10 years ago to cancer, and I see the struggle every day with him and her. We're getting married on her birthday. Have a reason to celebrate her birth. And I don't know what it would be like to lose a parent. I hurt for them. I don't know the words. I don't have them. I know they're suffering. The only thing I can say is she's so much better off. Y'all know her health and her struggles that she had, and I've been gone for so many years not to be here to help him with that. I'm here for you all. I don't know how to help you other than to pray for you, and I do it daily. So I love you guys very much, and I pray that God is able to keep her joy alive in you because you guys are such an inspiration to me. And I thank every one of you and their siblings, I mean their spouses. I think their spouses reflect. Amen.
Is anybody else? Yes.
Just to be, we have Ryan. I've known Rhonda since kindergarten. Marilyn was my homeroom teacher from kindergarten to fifth grade. And my name is Sandy Mahan. And I actually, Rhonda found me on Facebook a year ago. I had seen her since high school. I actually saw Laura and Marilyn. I was working at the VA. The dad is in the hospital then, and I actually briefly talked to him in the hospital. And I actually went and visited with Marilyn last June. I take care of my mom and my mother-in-law and worked full-time, but I took the time and I went and saw her at Southwest. I spent 2 hours listening to her tell me stories from my childhood. And she gave me so much, brought back so many memories, and I would check them out of that. Y'all are all family, but this is one child from the grade school that loved her mother very much, and she meant the world to me, and I was glad that mom found me on Facebook to give me the chance, because when she passed away, I was so thankful that I had taken the time at the work on that and said, I'm going to go see her, and it's something I will always have.
Anyone else? Spend time freely, speak out. And, you know, if you're not speaking out, that's okay. Because God knows what's in your heart. He knows. A lot of people do get shy, don't speak in front of others. But they know. Every one of you folks around here, you know each other pretty well. You know their spirit. You know their heart. You know each and every one of them would help each other any day of the week. You know that. And you may say, oh, I don't know about so-and-so. Well, we do have our times. But down deep, yes. Yes, they will. You do have a good spirit, heart. I can sense it in this room. Because Mary, the things that I have heard, and I can sense this in my spirit, the joy, the type of person she was, the honor that she gave you. That's why we sung this song. She got up when she didn't feel good. But yet, she did the very best she could. Just to help you all. But that love is straight from heaven. It is God's love. And it's deep, deep within her heart. And she wants you to be like that. And she does say, I love each and every one of you. And even the ones that could not make it, she loves you. She does want you to know. If there's no one else that has something to say, we'll close. Go ahead.
Well, she had a sense of humor, so I told her once, I said, did you know that the wise men were firemen? I said, she said, how do you know that? Yes, I said, well, because when they show up, they say, we come from afar.
Amen. This is what Marilyn wants. You're not going to see a frown on Marilyn's face. You will not see a sorrow on her face. You're going to see smiles and happiness. She has no problems in her body. She has that spiritual body. And folks, believe it or not, you can have that body here on earth of that love flowing from head to toe, and you will not feel any pain. Things are different now. I'm telling you, I would not be up here just speaking just words. I am experiencing it. Of people being healed. Sometimes people don't get healed. And I don't understand, but I'm learning. And we all are learning. Why this? Why did this have to happen? Why did it have to happen so quick? Was it my fault that I didn't do it? No, it was not your fault. So if anybody is in here blaming yourself for something, don't. God wants you to know this. No. There's things that you don't understand. But we're going to learn. We'll never, ever learn it all here. But when we go, we will have joy. We will know so much more. But you won't want it when you go to heaven. So is there anyone else that likes this?
I just want to say, she's the best mother ever. I haven't been with her in the last 22 years. I'd like to tell my family here that I'm sorry I wasn't here to help you. I wish I'd been here to help you, but Mom. I don't have to talk. I just love everyone. I miss everyone. I miss my mom. She was the best ever. I couldn't love her.
You have felt love. And you know what? Marilyn has brought you that love and showed you here on earth personally that love. She said, just believe. Just believe. Anyone else? We've had good sayings here today. Everybody's spoken from my heart. Let's close and say a prayer. Unless someone else wants to speak up. Heavenly Father, you are on the throne over everything, over our bodies, over our minds, over our situations, over every day and night as we sleep. We want to thank you, Lord, for taking care of Marilyn and her sisters that have gone, one before her and one after. We know that they are enjoying each other up there, plus the family and her mom and dad. And we know soon we will join them. I pray, Lord, for each person in this room, a blessing come upon each one. Touch them like never before. I speak this out. In Jesus' name, send forth your love to follow me every day. Amen. I want to speak. Now that we've closed, I see y'all have a gathering here and snack and do what you want. Enjoy each other. And as a minister, if anyone has any pain in your body, I'm serious on this. If you've got a headache, pain, shoulders, whatever, come and see me afterwards. I want to pray for you, and I promise you, because God promises you. That's where I get my promise from. That pain's going to go away. His love is upon you. It's odd, but He's here. He is really here. And it's no man. We've had ministers pray for us before, but things are different. It's been hundreds and hundreds, and I just want to say this. Laura here is a very good testimony. She got a goal too. God put it in her, fixed that one of them old black mountain buildings instantly. If you haven't seen it, God said it was beautiful. But God did that. Not Gary, not anybody else, just God. So God bless and enjoy y'all. was asking, was to vote for y'all. Father, we thank you for the blessing that you poured out upon us today. We thank you for the food that you nourish our bodies with. Thank you, Lord, that you treat each and every one of them for, and most of all, the relationship. And give you the honor and praise for everything you do.